So the latest so-called coincidence in this continuing story of unexplained similarities between albums put out by The Roots compared to albums put out first by Philly rapper, beatmaker, visual artist Shaun Abu is a new song by Black Thought called Aquamarine, which coincidentally is also a song by Shaun Abu from the album Moonshine released in 2006. I haven't heard Black Thought's song yet to compare the lyrics between the two, but when I do, if there are lyrical similarities, I'll post a new video comparing them. And just FYI, I am the artist formerly known as Shaun Abu, and I'll detail my first-hand experience in the Philly indie hip-hop scene by just stating the verifiable facts that can be confirmed by multiple sources, but most importantly, by copyright records that can be searched by anyone via the U.S. Copyright Office at copyright.gov. Copyright dates cannot be changed, so it's a good source to establish a chronological timeline. You can amend a copyright, meaning you can add something to an existing copyright, but you can't make that update earlier than the date of the original copyright. And this is a good time to show you the Moonshine album copyright. As you can see, the copyright date is November 24th, 2006, and song number 3 is titled Aquamarine. And this is the online public record searchable at copyright.gov. And this is the Seeds of Evolution copyright, which was my first release in the Philly music scene and what most of this comparison concerns. This is the physical copyright registration for Seeds of Evolution, Volume 1 for copyright purposes. And this is the online public record you can find at copyright.gov. As you can see, the copyright date of the full album is May 19th, 1998. And I'm the claimant, Sean Witherspoon. Also, these are the copyright records for Things Fall Apart by The Roots. As you can see, the earliest copyright that exists for Things Fall Apart is for the songs Don't See Us and Adrenaline, which has a copyright date of December 14, 1998, and a release date of November 24, 1998, which is about 6 to 7 months after the release of Seeds of Evolution. And the rest of Things Fall Apart seems to be covered by a single sound recording copyright dated March 29, 1999. And the album release date is February 23, 1999, making the release and copyright of Things Fall Apart at least 9 months after the release and copyright of Seeds of Evolution. So I'll also point out some other relevant details while visually and audibly comparing album artwork and song lyrics that I put out locally in Center City, Philly in the South Street area compared to what The Roots put out afterwards nationally via their major label releases. So some quick backstory, if you're not from Philly or weren't around this music scene between 1997 and 2007, you probably never heard of Shaun Abu or Seeds of Evolution. Seeds of Evolution is the name of my first group and also the self-titled name of the album that I put out independently in the spring of 1998 on my indie label called The Sonar Recording Company. I only had enough money saved to manufacture a project, so we couldn't afford to go into a real studio, but we had grown attached to a mixtape I made of the rough demo versions of the songs we were working on that we recorded with basic analog equipment. So the album as it plays on the CD is the same cassette mixtape sent to the copyright office of 4-track demos that were ultimately packaged professionally on CD at a time when it was rare that an unsigned group had a proper CD demo. So the look of the album and the promotional materials were polished, but the actual music was not. And four of the songs on the album were also pressed on 12-inch vinyl. So I produced the beats along with John and Scott Weiss and Julian Griff, who were the other members of the group. I wrote the lyrics and I also drew the album cover, which was first just a standalone drawing I made, but I wound up using it as the album cover because the rest of the group really liked the concept. The concept came from studying the Islam of Saudi Arabia and wanting to learn how to draw Arabic calligraphy, which to me is like the dopest graffiti hand I'd ever seen. So while practicing that script, I came across a few prayers that kind of looked like this and gave me the general idea, something like this and this. But I wanted to draw it in a way that made it look more like a human head bowed in prayer. So I made room for a forehead here, added a closed eye here, moved the prayer slash brain back a bit, added a border, and painted it with watercolors to make it look like the sky at sunset. Later, my bandmate Jules drew the Seeds of Evolution logo, and with the help of a graphic design student, I added the logo to the drawing. So when you look at the final image, you see the side profile of a person's head bowed in prayer with eyes closed at sunset. And the Arabic prayer lets the viewer decipher what the person is thinking while praying, and that's what makes it a clever drawing or album cover for my purposes. It's a visible and readable mind when normally you can't see what someone's thinking while they're doing something. The prayer basically translates to praise in the name of God, most gracious, most merciful. Do you see a familiar concept here? I also took some photos with the help of a friend for the CD booklet and used these photos alternately for promotional purposes. So I had about 1,000 stickers made of the album cover, and we made photocopied black and white flyers of the insert images to promote the release, our shows, and any related events. So in the spring of 98, we put these stickers and flyers everywhere in Center City, Philly, in the South Street area where you could buy music, see a music performance, go to a nightclub, grab a cup of coffee, get something to eat, you know, make sure that they were at every hot spot in the city that we anticipated our audience might be. And our marketing efforts got a good response from the indie crowd, particularly the album cover sticker, because the colors popped against the backdrop of the city and people liked the originality of the concept. The album had such good word of mouth that a year after its release, it found its way into the May 1999 issue of the CMJ New Music Monthly magazine, which was a big deal to us because the College Music Journal was an important source of independent music and new music in general. So back to the spring of 98, I put the sticker on all the 12-inch vinyl like this. We had about 300, and I consigned them in all the record stores in Center City and on South Street that sold indie hip-hop vinyl. I also had 300 CDs manufactured, and I was able to consign those at major retail chain record stores like Sam Goody, HMV, Tower Records, Strawberries Records, and other mom-and-pop shops that sold CDs as well. To consign something, for those who don't know, means to give copies of your work in advance to a store to sell stuff like it, and if they sell, you get paid and they order more. And if they don't, you get your copies back. You do this when you don't have a distributor. Since the album was basically a well-packaged demo, it was only released in downtown Philadelphia. So during the course of the spring, summer, fall, and winter of 98, we had all the important places in the city covered with stickers and flyers, had the vinyl and CD consigned in stores everywhere we could, and would give records and CDs away as promos at shows and at other venues. The point was to create awareness, get the word out, you know, and just to see what we can do in terms of maybe finding a music manager to help develop our ideas and get us closer to a real record deal. At this point, I want to show you a timeline of the Roots album cover images up to the point of the Seeds of Evolution release to show you what they were doing visually with album artwork before the Seeds of Evolution album dropped and what they did afterwards. So we have Organics, which is a blank black canvas with white font. Do You Want More, which is a blue-hued group photo. We have Illadelph Half-Life, which is a panoramic sepia-colored group photo. I'm including the singles from Illadelph Half-Life because Seeds of Evolution dropped sometime after the last single from Illadelph Half-Life. So we have Clones, No Frills Design, Concerto of a Desperado, which is a gold-colored single jacket for vinyl, and What They Do, which is a Meet the Beatles-esque silhouette group photo. This is the point when the Seeds of Evolution sticker and insert images go up around the city and the vinyl and CD drops in the spring slash early summer of 1998. Then fast forward to February 1999. The Roots released these alternate album covers for Things Fall Apart, such as this, 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 ultimately settling on this. And then in 2002, they released the album Phrenology. But I want to go back to the content of Things Fall Apart, because the similarities don't end with just cover art and insert photos. So on the Seeds of Evolution album, again, copyright May 19th, 1998, there's a love song of sorts called Black Emmanuel that's a story about being caught or infatuated by an exotic-looking girl from Philly with the French Association. The French Association here is the name Emmanuel, which is a reference to a series of French movies from the 1970s. There's a song called Magma that's about the movement of beats and rhymes flowing like hot lava. There's a song that celebrates hip-hop culture called Creatures of Habitat. There's an abstract battle rap song called Mysterions that contains mystic references and counterintuitive wordplay. And there's also a hidden track at the end of the CD. As you can see on the back of the CD, there's 11 songs listed. But when I put the CD into a media player, there are 12 tracks listed. The 12th song is the hidden track called Meditation Medicine. So as many of you know, on Things Fall Apart by The Roots, there's a love song called You Got Me that's a story with a premise about being caught or infatuated by an exotic-looking girl from Philly with a French association. There's a song called The Next Movement, which is about a new movement of hot music. There's a song that celebrates hip-hop culture called Act 2, Love of My Life. There's an abstract battle rap song called Don't See Us that contains mystic references and counterintuitive wordplay. And there's also a hidden track at the end of the CD. As you can see on the back of the CD, there's 17 songs listed, but when I pull up the Spotify track list, there are 18 tracks listed. The 18th song is the hidden track on the CD version of the album called Act 4, The End. And there are also very similar lyrical passages between these parallel songs that express the same points and contain nearly the same punchlines. So for this audio comparison, I'll play the Seeds of Evolution audio first with the lyrics written out in text, and then I'll play the similar quote from Things Fall Apart with the lyrics written out in text so we can compare the lyric content as well as the flow of the lines. So to recap, the quotes from The Roots you'll see here are copywritten at least 6 months after the local Philly release of Seeds of Evolution, and here are some of those passages and punchlines.
You're now consulting with the microsurgeon, the Iron Curtain.
You are now in tune to the sounds of the legendary foundation.
You're nervous, kid. I haven't even scratched the surface yet.
Your head is throbbing and I ain't said shit yet.
I've emerged from the depths like the log.
The bald dice rise like a creature from out the swamp.
I rock the foot the kids who sported that lace. Gazelles and stone face, bombers and windbreakers.
Rockin' gazelle, got goals and eyes are closed.
Gazelles and stone face.
Faces the stone.
Taking this trigonometry, geometrical calculus.
Lyrically calculus and it's arithmetic.
I'll rob you cause you're slovenly to slide like bobsled.
Slip a hole into a nigga pocket. Take sneaks, chains, and ranks and bracelets.
I swear to uphold the honor.
I swear solemnly that I'll forever.
This microphone wires a virus when it connects.
The mic cord is an extension of my intestine.
What did you expect? I bring these molten words to fret.
Thumping, what was your assumption?
Searching for a possible rival, but they're all myopic.
Stand over, whichever mute, minuscule mic holder.
Travel throughout the stars in the arms of Orion.
You stargazing, but you're the force y'all facing is the...
Absolutely the solution with the nutrients.
Then the antidote came.
There are arguably more of those, but to keep things moving, consider all the details in these next lines from Black Emmanuel from Seeds of Evolution, which contain the basic storyline of Black Thought's narrative in You Got Me.
Sure, what made it seem so pure, but I wanted more of her exotic allure, not to mention that she complimented what I stand for. It tortured my soul, y'all, I craved it. Who would have thought I would be caught by this most obscure Asian? Mahogany complected, sensuous pheromones detected. My sensory is telling me, inspect it, check it out. I fell under the spell of Black Emmanuel. For tonight, I'll pick a night, Emmanuel. It was raining on a Saturday, relaxing the songs by Donnie Hathaway. Opened a book, got bored, so I put that away and started thinking of her. Glanced at the cloud cover, then buzz with my buzzer. Guess who was at my door with no umbrella?
Until I'm overseas on tour and peep this Ethiopian queen from Philly taking classes abroad. She said she loved my show in Paris at Elise Momar. Did you think not? Think the thought went home and forgot. Time passed, we back in Philly, now she up in my spot. Telling me the things I'm telling of is making her hot. Started building with her constantly round the clock. Now she in my world like hip hop and keep telling me, yeah.
To lyricists particularly, consider the counterintuitiveness or reverse logic of this next line from the song Mysterions compared to a similar style in a line by Dice Raw on Don't See Us. Subliminal disses are when a rapper describes someone or their style to a T, but doesn't mention their name specifically, or mentions them in a backhanded way, leaving the listener to figure out who the rapper's talking about. So as I mentioned before, my indie record label was called the Sonar Recording Company, and sonar is an underwater system used to map the ocean for exploration purposes. So since my style of rap back then was considered underground, the subsurface reference to sonar made sense to me. So for the subliminal disses, I'll start with the two quotes from The Roots that reference sonar.
First we handling, first thing, I'm subsurface unseen.
Underwater rap, you know who the boss is in.
On stage, I make you see to an off on.
Mr. Superficial, I'm ripping apart your heart tissue. This is your official dismissal. I don't study the artificial. Who fucking with the dark crystal? Yo, what art is you? We go back like ancients, while you ancients.
Plus a mission is denied, so just wait outside. Two extremes collide like Jekyll and Hyde.
Mr. High Post, you about to get shot down. Trying to fly above the Silla Fifth compound.
Look at all the scavengers, all wanna be contenders. Never let an outside nigga slide dead. This ain't home plate.
I lace your function, make it a Black Thought production. Word up, I'm on something.
So by comparison of song concepts and lyrics, it seems for every single released on the Roots Breakthrough album, Things Fall Apart, there's a parallel song complete with similar lyrics on Seeds of Evolution, which is an album that was released almost a year earlier and only in the Center City Philly indie hip-hop music scene. Plus, both albums have a hidden track. Can you name another rap CD released before 1998 that has a hidden track? Given the verifiable copyright dates, how can all these lyrical and conceptual similarities be coincidental? To people who know hip-hop culture, particularly rap culture, are there supposed to be any parallels whatsoever between rap albums, indie or major, especially from this era? So given all the verifiable similarities, it seems select content from Seeds of Evolution can be found in the core content of Things Fall Apart, while Phrenology reinterprets Seeds of Evolution's album cover. So when we look at the two, the first and the second, the core concept of both album covers is that you are able to see a person's brain from a side profile, and upon closer inspection, you can decipher a meaning to what's drawn in place of the brain. While the first illustration is drawn more abstractly, and the second is drawn more realistically, the only real difference between the two drawings is what can be deciphered in the minds of these drawings. The Seeds of Evolution visible brain translates from Arabic to praise in the name of God, the most gracious, most merciful, while the Roots visible brain depicts what culminates into a particular mindset. But regardless of what's depicted in the minds of these two illustrations, the core concept is the same, a visible and decipherable mind. So while I was researching this video, I came across an article in the riverfronttimes.com that interviews the artist hired to create the Roots album cover for Phrenology. So they didn't draw it themselves, they hired an artist named Tom Huck to draw their idea. So the article states that the Roots told MCA Records that they had an idea for an album cover, and they wanted MCA to reach out to Tom Huck to illustrate it because they had seen some work of his. And Tom Huck describes the back and forth process of creating the album cover art with the Roots. Here's a quote from that interview, and I'll leave a link to this article in the bio section. It was very chaotic doing it. We were doing faxes of my approved drawings. The band wanted a certain look, and they wanted me because I do that antique look of woodcut. There's that age-old look to my stuff. They wanted those old Phrenology drawings of the head. They had a list of the faculties they wanted to go into the brain. Well, if anything, Arabic calligraphy is age-old. As the illustrator of the Seeds of Evolution drawing, what strikes me as similar first between the two drawings is the border that frames the entire image. Also the shape by the ear around faculty number 10, this Rosa Parks area here. I can see a corresponding area on the Seeds of Evolution drawing here. Also the turntables in faculty number 13 reminds me of this area here of calligraphic flourishes. And faculty number 2 on the Phrenology drawing, which is the question mark that's meant to indicate spirituality according to their booklet. I see a parallel here in the same area on the Seeds of Evolution drawing here. And by the way, Phrenology is considered a pseudoscience, the same as bloodletting. So fast forward to December 2002, I put three songs and instrumentals on vinyl from a solo album I've been working on called Come In And Take A Look At Your Mind. Kind of a continuation of my original idea, but recorded better. So to promote the album, I go around to all the clubs that play underground hip-hop and give each DJ copies of the 12-inch vinyl EP. One Monday night, I go to a club called Fluid to give a DJ named Mike Nice copies of the 12-inch, and Amir Questlove Thompson happens to be there too, standing outside. So I give him copies of the vinyl, because he's a DJ, and I'm still thinking they might look out at that point. Later in 2003, when the full album is complete, I'm walking on 15th and Chestnut Street handing out promos of the album to passerbys, and Black Thought walks by while I'm handing out the promos, so he gets a promo. Then in 2010, the Roots released this album cover artwork for their album, How I Got Over. Then in 2017, Black Thought poses at the site of the Come In And Take A Look At Your Mind album cover. And as recent as 2022, Black Thought has coincidentally released a song named Aquamarine, which is not a typical title for a rap song, but also happens to be a title of a song from my 2006 album Moonshine, that was promoted in the same way as my other releases, but on a slightly smaller scale. To say the least, I don't believe in this type of coincidence. How are all these similarities possible between two rap groups that are not friends or collaborators, but just lived and did business in the same part of the city and had reasonable access to the few independent hip-hop outlets that were available? I have to mention at this point that I personally saw Black Thought here in the summer of 98, where promos of Seeds of Evolution were available. And since I lived over top of this coffee shop and knew the staff, I know people that work there that are still living and breathing today who saw the Roots drummer Amir Questlove Thompson there too during this time, as well as at other places where the Seeds of Evolution promo was available. So today, most people that were in that downtown center city indie hip-hop scene seem to have forgotten or are acting on the implied instructions to don't say nothing. But the verifiable facts show clearly the Roots have come back to the source of their biggest successes again, 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 and again.